What's up, everybody? Tegan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today, we are reviewing something special, the Hestia by Vaonis. Through its unique combination of optics, prisms, and a companion app called Gravity, the Hestia transforms your smartphone into a smart telescope. So the Hestia by Vaonis comes in two packages, the standard package and the premium package. Today we're gonna be reviewing the premium package. So let's get into it, and we're gonna share with you why the Hestia is shaping out to be a powerful tool for viewing the solar system and the night sky. This is the Hestia by Vaonis. The Hestia consists of a 30mm lens for 25 times more magnification than your smartphone alone. Around the lens is a simple but reliable focuser that twists. On the face of the Hestia, where the eyepiece lies, are magnetic brackets to secure your smartphone to the Hestia's eyepiece. Next up is the tripod. This tripod comes with three extendable legs to a height of around 5 feet. The tripod head moves up and down and from left to right and has tension adjustments for a more precise movement of the Hestia. The tripod head includes a mounting shoe. This mounting shoe threads into the bottom of the Hestia, and once removed from the tripod and attached to the Hestia, simply reattach the assembly to the tripod. Now, before you perform this step, download the Gravity app, as you'll need to scan the QR code on the body of the Hestia to access the features and follow the instructions. Lastly, you'll also find a solar filter and a sun finder. These come with the Hestia Premium Package. More on these later in the video. Lastly, you'll be happy to see that the Hestia and its accessories come all within a nice case. So as you can see, setting up the Hestia is extremely simple, but it's only half of the equation. The other half that we have yet to talk about is the Gravity app, upon which the entire Hestia experience is designed. Let's talk about it now in a bit more detail. When you first launch the Gravity app, you'll come to the home screen, which has two options, Moon Mode and Sun Mode. For our purposes, we're going to call these shortcuts. They give you information about the moon, its position and distance, as well as about the sun and its position and distance. However, click on the camera button down in the middle of the app and you'll then have access to all five imaging modes. We found these are a great starting point, and they've given us the most joy and success when using the Hestia. Let's start off with scenery mode. Scenery mode allows you to point freely around your environment. In scenery mode, you can adjust the exposure time, ISO, the framing, and focus. These adjustments are offered on each mode, so starting with scenery allows you to become familiar with them. To adjust the focus, twist the lens on the front of the Hestia until focus is as sharp as you can achieve. If you want it a bit better, the Gravity app offers an in-camera focus routine. Simply hit Focus Assistant, and the phone will take 20 photos at different focus points and will prompt you to choose the frame that is the sharpest. I really enjoyed using this as a starting point because the images were great, the views were pleasing, and it was just a pleasure to use in general. We're going to jump around here a bit and show you the lunar mode next. Simply click the drop-down menu and choose Moon from the menu. Now, as the Hestia does not have any electronics in it, it's not going to move automatically to the moon. It asks that you move the Hestia and center it manually. Given the 25 times magnification, this is still an easy task and doesn't require much effort. Once the moon is center, repeat the setting adjustments that we made in scenery mode and find the best focus and exposure and ISO settings to your liking. Now let's compare an image of the moon with the Hestia and just through my smartphone. Alright, so now we come upon the imaging mode that we are most excited for, the sun mode. After having successfully used the scenery mode and the lunar mode, I had a good sense that I was able to navigate the solar mode. Now, before we go on, here's a solar warning. Never ever look at the sun without the proper solar glasses or without the proper solar filters. That being said, make sure you are following the solar filter installation instructions provided by the Vaonis Hestia. The installation instructions do a good job of showing how to center the sun. But if you need to see the instructions again, simply tap the three dots on the top right and rewatch the installation instructions. Once aligned, the sun should be visible through your camera. Now you can adjust your exposure time, ISO, and focus as you have with the other two imaging modes we've covered. If the sun is active that day, you should be able to see some incredible sunspots. You can even download these photos from your phone onto your computer into a stacking software and process them even further for more details and richer color. This can be done on any of the imaging modes, but we found the solar mode is the most fun to do the stacking and the processing. Let's take a look at the sun through the Hestia and the sun through my iPhone. So up until now, each of the imaging modes that we've discussed, scenery, sun, and moon mode, have required minimal interaction from the Hestia. Up until now. Now we're going to talk about the deep sky imaging mode, and this is where that changes. So before we get into it, we are currently using the iPhone 14. The deep sky mode doesn't work with all phones just yet. If you want to use this feature, then we recommend that you continuously check the link to Vaonis' requirements to see if they've updated it. So that being said, let's get into the deep sky imaging mode. With the deep sky mode, the Gravity app uses a very common astronomy technique called plate solving, and this helps identify where you are pointing in relation to the object you are trying to find. Plate solving is an incredibly helpful feature given the dim nature of these deep sky objects. It's much easier to use plate solving to find your object than it is to use the Sky Atlas or to search for it manually. It's simply too difficult and too frustrating. Start by choosing Deep Sky from the drop-down menu. You'll then be prompted to select the best objects to view based on your location. Once you select an object, you'll be presented with a screen that looks similar to the other modes, but this screen has more information. You'll first notice the nifty blue glow coming from your phone. This is a rough indicator on which direction to move the Hestia. And as you move the Hestia, the blue glow changes, ensuring you know which direction to go. The compass on the bottom left is the fine alignment section, which shows you how many degrees up, down, left, and right you need to move. Then you'll also see on the right there's a star analysis indicator. This is the Hestia continuously updating your current pointing location in real time, which will be reflected by the compass and blue glow. This is the process we mentioned called plate solving. Simply move the Hestia in the direction of your object, wait for a successful star analysis, which updates the compass, and then move closer to your object and repeat this process. After a few short moments, you'll be able to center the deep sky object in the Hestia and see it come to life. Similar to those modes, you can save these images and post-process in your favorite software to pull out more detail. However, we were pleasantly surprised at what could be achieved with just your phone, the Hestia, and the Gravity Companion app. All right, so now we move on to the last imaging mode that the Hestia offers, the Planetary imaging mode. So as always, start from the drop-down menu and select Planets. You'll immediately be asked to select which planet you'd like to view. Now, the Hestia doesn't currently plate solve in this imaging mode, and like the moon imaging mode, you're going to need to be able to find the planets manually. After locating the planet, you can adjust the camera settings as we have before. Here you can see four of Jupiter's brightest moons. We can reduce the exposure time and the ISO, and the planet becomes more dim and takes on a more spherical shape. Okay, so thank you for tuning in. That is our review of the Hestia by Vaonis. If you have any questions at all, please let us know in the comments below, and our team will be more than happy to assist. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any future content over all things astronomy and astrophotography. I'm Tegan with High Point. Clear skies.